In the reduce phase, there is more work to be done in pulling the data that is needed for each one of these reduces, because we know that the mappers have been executing on different nodes of the computational cluster, and they produced their intermediate results as files on their local disk. And this worker that is carrying out a particular split of the reduce operation has to reach out and pull the data from all of the M mappers that have stored their intermediate results on their respective local disks. So there is remote read that is involved as the first thing in the reduce phase is to pull the data. This is part of what I mean by the plumbing that the runtime system provides, is to recognize that for this reduce operation to work, it needs the mapping results from all the M nodes that carried out the map function. And so it is going to do RPC in order to get all this data from all the local disks of the nodes on which the map is executed. And once it has all the data, it can sort it and then call the reduce function. Reduce function is the one that has been written by the domain expert, and this is the point at which the domain expertise comes in saying, well, I've got the data now, let me do the processing that I want to do for the reduce operation. The sorting that is being done as part of the programming framework may be to sort the input that is coming in from all of these different mappers so that all the same keys are together in the input data set that is going to be given to the reduce function. And once such sorting has been done, the programming framework will call the user supplied reduce function for each key with the set of intermediate values so that the reduce function can do its thing, which is domain specific. Each reduce function will then write to the final output file specific to the partition that it is dealing with. So if you think about the original example that we started with, if let's say this guy is accumulating all the instances of the name Kishore, then it will write the output file that says, oh, I found so many instances of the name Kishore in the input corpus of data. And similarly, this guy may be doing it for another name like Drew or Arun and so on. And once each worker has completed its work by writing its final output file for this partition that it is responsible for, then it informs the master that, yes, I'm done with the work that was assigned to me. The user program can be woken up when all the reducers have indicated to the master that they've done their work, and at that point, the MapReduce computation that is initiated by the user program is complete. We said that there could be M splits of the input data set, meaning the input key values pairs, and there could be R splits of the output that has to be generated by the application as a whole. Now, the computational resources that are available in the data center, N, may be less than the sum M plus R. So there may not be a unique machine to assign for each one of the M splits that have been made. It is the responsibility of the master to manage the machines and assign the machines that are available to handling the M input data sets as well as the R reduce splits that need to be generated. So this is part of the heavy lifting that has to be done by the runtime. So for instance, let's say that I have only 100 worker nodes available as mappers and I have an input split of 1,000, then what I'm going to do is I'm going to assign one split to this worker. And when the guy says, I'm done with it, then I'll say, oh, you're done? Okay, take the next split and work on it. So that's how we're going to manage the available resources for carrying out the work that needs to be done. So remember that this is all done as part of the heavy lifting by the runtime. The user doesn't have to worry about it. All that the user did was write the map function and write the reduce function, and the rest of it is magic so far as the MapReduce framework is concerned. And similarly, the number of R splits specified by the user may be more than the number of workers that are available to carry that out. And in that case, again, the master is going to assign a particular split to this worker so that he can compute and generate the output file corresponding to that split. Once he's done with that and notifies the master, then the master will say, okay, now that you're done with that, work on the next split. And it'll do all the work that is associated with plumbing, meaning bringing the data for the split that a particular worker is working on right now, sorting it to put all the corresponding keys together, and then finally calling the reduce function that has been written by the user. That's the kind of work that goes on under the covers in the programming framework of MapReduce.